doing okay with it, but give you a magic box. This one has zombies in it. I just don't understand. It's like secret of another game or something. Ooh. I'll take that. That looks nice. I'm coming up behind you. Look out, motherfuckers! Buddy. Oh, what the hell? No, get off of me. Instant kill. Move, guys, move, move, come on, move it. Get your asses over there. Oh, bitch, get off me. Oh, bitch, get off me, I said. Just seen a fucking box. Where'd it go? Everywhere. like to look everywhere. It gives you a lot of clientele to look for. Alright, on your mark, dude. Dingo. Look at that. Dingo. Oh. My first gun.
Familiar screech. Parasites, mutated creatures born out of 6115, were flying towards us.
Get up, get up. You gotta take off. See ya. This far on campaign mode and on this mode. 60 meters. Like, not the hell there. There's a bee! Get off me, fucking bird. Heinrich, you okay? Let's push on, guys.
With the shipping yard cleared, Cloud Mountain was just ahead. The server room at the top. We had a long climb ahead of us.
Open that door so the robots. Open. Thank you. Take out that robot. Usually I die. Yeah, have a game. Come on, robot, you're gonna be wasting your time. Let's go. Instinct kill. Sweeping the place. here so far. Unboxed back here. Nothing there. Nothing there. Dead soldier. Going upstairs. Claire. Coming up, Sarge. Let's go. Oh, what the fuck? No, 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 I don't want to die. No, what the fuck? here we go. Now it's my time. It's party time! Ooh, party time! We're having a party!
In the server room.
By the time we got there, Gojulan encrypted her hardware, locking us out of the central server. Hendrix stepped in, but we were a few seconds too late. Damage was done.
Why did she lock you out?
It didn't make any sense. Sure, we weren't on the best of terms, but this wasn't her. Something else made her do it. Something was controlling her. The encryption used a biometric hand scan. Hendrix tried to unlock it. But the Go siblings were smart. They'd set up an access system requiring both of their hands for authorization. And her brother was shredded with bullets back in the bar. We could hear the horde coming, and we only had one sibling. But she did have two hands.
You chose to cut off her hand. Why?
I hoped the biometrics were interchangeable, allowing the siblings to use either reader. If we were calling transport and getting out alive, it had to work. Lucky for us, it did. Hendrix interfaced with the system. He was able to raise WA command. We needed a ride out ASAP. They had a VTOL a few minutes out. Rendezvous was set for the top of the dome. But Hendrix wanted to know what Gojulan had on Taylor. Anything, even the smallest detail, would be helpful in picking up his trail. That would take some time. And time was something we didn't have. Hendrix searched the archives. I dealt with the incoming horde.
Little good bitches to me. Oh shit. I'm up here. Is that all you got? knock your head off. Where'd you go?
Hendrix had pulled all the data he could. I hoped it was enough. Our pickup was in position. It's time to get the hell out of here.
Going up.
Our bird wasn't alone in the sky. Our VTOL had caught the attention of an old automated race. We needed to find his own way.
Going down.
This Wraith telling you.
Hopefully I beat this one, then I can beat the Korea mode. Korea mode and Nightmares are basically based on the same thing.
Targeting anything and everything is an enemy.
But
just like that.
This is a nightmare.
Except on a much larger,
from all the soldiers
more
that I killed in the
Korea mode. And this one was very interested in us. Command had an exit route. Extraction set beyond the swamps. If we crossed the super trees, there were shipping docks where we could commandeer an airboat. It's easier said than done. Between the flesh eaters and that wraith eyeing us, a super tree could be no walk in the park. We had to haul ass and stay out of sight. But they weren't our only concern. Winslow Accord picked up chatter ahead. Apparently, we weren't the only humans using the docks to escape.
What the hell?
We had to haul ass and stay out of sight. But they weren't our only concern. Winslow Accord picked up chatter ahead. Apparently, we weren't the only humans using the docks to escape.
What the fuck?
We had to haul ass and stay out of sight. But they weren't our only concern. Winslow Accord picked up chatter ahead. Apparently, we weren't the only humans using the docks to escape.
Coming.
Super tree was collapsing. The only safe route to the docks was up. Chatter confirmed the 54 immortals were scrambling to get out of the biodomes through the swamps.
What the fuck? Come on! Fucking pissing me off. Now I gotta start from the beginning.
The super tree was collapsing. The only safe route to the docks was up. Chatter confirmed the 54 immortals were scrambling to get out of the biodomes through the swamps.
Bye-bye! Going up!
From the sound of it, they wanted us dead as much as the Flesh Eaters did.
Geronimo!
Looked like we were jumping from one bad situation into another.
Even the floor. Granted, I never did it before, but doing it now. Up there.
Hendrix commandeered an airboat and set the autopilot. We had undead on our ass, and more 54i ahead. And that rogue wraith wasn't done with us yet.
escape.
Our expo was just ahead. We were getting out.
What about Taylor? What did Hendrix learn from the server?
Nothing. It had been wiped. Taylor was in the wind. And the virus. 6115 wouldn't stop this time. The Winslow Accord and CDP had been thrown into chaos. We'd lost Hong Kong, Berlin, and Cairo. And it was just getting started. What would come next? How the world would change? There was no way to be ready for that.
Five long, dark years. Opening the quarantine zones did exactly as we feared. And by 2075, what was a contained situation gave way to anarchy. Humanity's numbers had been reduced to a few hundred mil scattered across the globe. The undead had risen to 7 billion. Taylor was in the wind, a faded reminder of our inability to stop Armageddon. There was still a Winslow Accord kill on sight ordinance in place, but he was a distant memory. Until the aquifers. We were on a routine bombing run outside Cairo. Our orders were to bomb the dead into the next life. Our target was a Catartus colony. They'd taken over a refinery. It was a well-armed facility protecting them from the dead they worshipped. Top priority was to cut off their comms and leave them in the dark. But first, we had to clear out their defenses. This was a routine sweep. Every time another sympathizer colony sprouted up, we'd squash it back down. As far as we were concerned, we were doing the world a favor. We moved on the array, but the undead sympathizers weren't going down without a fight. Disabling the comms would take some time. Our support detail dealt with that. I dealt with reinforcements. The station disabled, we had to get back to our bird. The array was ahead. Bring it down, we'd be one step closer to eradicating this colony. Our support detail needed a few moments to disable the array. Lucky for me, I had more hostiles to keep me occupied.
What the hell, man? Really?
Comms disabled, we needed to get back in the air.
Fucking birds. Damn, how many fucking ones do we have to do?
With their comms jammed, really? The next step was to breach the control room to take back the facility. There was access ahead. I just needed to get through the flooded room in front of me. Our support detail insisted on coming with.
When you were swimming, something went wrong.
Our D&I. There was a malfunction.
What did you see?
I saw. I was drowning. I thought I heard.
This is not your time. Get back up. Do not trust him. Everything is not what it seems.
What did you hear?
Nothing. I couldn't make it out.
Get up.
Then I woke up. Someone pulled me out of the water. Someone saved me.
Saved you?
A guardian angel. Someone watching over me. My support detail. She got through somehow and pulled me out. She brought me back from the brink. She said it wasn't my time. My work wasn't done. I had to stop Taylor. I don't know how she knew. It didn't make any sense.
Did you know her? This woman?
No. I'd never worked with her before today.
And yet she knew about Taylor. She knew about what happened. And you're sure she was there?
What? Why? You think I made her up?
You yourself said your DNI systems were malfunctioning.
What? You gonna tell me I'm crazy next? I know what I saw. I did not make her up. I didn't fucking imagine her.
Did she have a name?
Of course she had a fucking name. The Guardian Angel. She said her name was Kane. She told me she'd help me get through this. She said we had to move. Control was beyond a server room ahead. If we were going to take the refinery from these dead sympathizers, we needed to clear it out. If we couldn't, it would be on to Plan B.
Plan B?
Plan bomb this shithole to hell. We prepped to breach, but it turns out our enemies planned ahead. The explosion blocked our path. We had to double back. It caught us off guard. But the noise also caught the undead's attention.
Damn.
We regrouped with our allies. That's Egyptian Army Lieutenant Ziad Khalil, friend of ours. He was durable, seasoned. He defended his home through undead wars. He wouldn't go down without a fight.
What was the plan?
Khalil would move on control from the exterior. I'd sweep the dead from the air. Our guardian angel accompanied me. She told me the answer to finding Taylor was on this refinery. Why she thought that. How she knew that. It was surreal. When Khalil took the control room, he found something on the security footage. Something we needed to see.
Taylor.
Mike seeing a ghost. We just stumbled upon him. This wasn't just a Cotardus colony. This was Taylor's hideout. They were already evacuating Taylor. We locked down the facility, separating Taylor and his associate, Moretti.
Who did you go after?
It was too late for Taylor. The Cotardus put him on a VTOL. We'd go after Moretti. Command informed us the kill order was still active. Hendricks didn't like that, but it wasn't his call.
How did you feel about
it? 5 years. 5 years after our fuck-up, and we could fix it. I'd gladly take the shot. Moretti was just below us. If we were gonna get him, we'd need to take a shortcut.
Shortcut?
A leap of faith.
Off me. Oh, you fucking bitch.
trust her. Find Taylor.
How was Hendricks coping with the change of plans?
He was upset. And why wouldn't he be? Command wanted our friends dead. He wanted to bring Moretti
alive. But that wasn't all, was it?
No. Hendricks had been different since Singapore.
In what way?
Every way. Aggressive, angry. He was losing perspective. And there... something was just off. I should have known
what
happened.
How could you have known? Even if you had, what could you have done? You seemed so certain of his intentions.
We all battle in our demons and our choices. Hendricks, Taylor, that whole team rose the ranks together, fought alongside each other. Friends. Little did we know one of his friends was watching us. Moretti had locked himself in the security room. Only way in was to cut the power. To do that, we had to overload the general.
Fuck, man.
Thank you.
You cornered him. What did Maretti say?
He said that name. Same as Diaz. Deimos. He said if I wanted answers, I had to find Damian Bishop. A man we both knew from a past mission. Bishop could help stop Deimos. But first, he kept saying, this isn't me. This isn't me. He kept saying Deimos made him do it. So I granted his last request. I killed him as he asked. I did our job. It didn't sit with
Hendricks.
Can
you blame him for his outburst?
Hendricks was pissed because Moretti was our link to finding Taylor. A link I just severed and split up. And the guilt I carried all those years that I channeled inward, Hendricks channeled outward. This was our chance to fix our mistake, and I fucked. Hendricks said I may as well have damned the world myself. I'd had to knock some sense into him. Sometimes it was the only way to get through. I told him what Moretti had told me about Bishop, Deimos, whoever the hell he was. The mention of Bishop got Hendricks' attention. Last we saw him was back in 65, 10 years ago in Ethiopia. How Bishop knew Deimos, but we'd figure this shit out, and we'd do it together. But right then, we had bigger problems. The Egyptian army couldn't hold the refinery. Plan bomb this shithole to hell was a go. We had to get out of there. Now!
Passed it. Now I gotta do it in fucking career mode.
This Bishop that Moretti mentioned?
Damian Bishop. The man who found the cure. A vaccination to make 6115 victims human again.
A cure? Did it work?
It should have. Something was blocking it. Bishop had this theory. He believed somewhere there was an undead brain. A single creature controlling them as a collective hive. He believed that it somehow blocked the cure. We met him in 2065 when he made the breakthrough. News traveled fast. He and a few others were kidnapped in Ethiopia. It was a joint op with Taylor's team. We were to extract Bishop from a base overrun by the dead.
What? Really? Overrun by the dead. Man, what the fuck have I got myself into? Black Ops.
With the dead crawling all over, we needed a distraction. Something to keep the flesh eaters occupied so we could grab Bishop. We weren't dead killers yet. So we had to be a little more creative. And lucky for us, there were plenty of NRC birds in the sky, and the NRC's dead system still worked. Laser cannons built to auto-target any hostile aircraft.
So you created the diversion.
And Taylor's team prepped extraction. Unfortunately, it seemed our cover wouldn't last as long as we hoped. The remaining NRC noticed the radio silence from air traffic control and had sent soldiers to investigate. Command set exfil for a satellite station off base. We reset the dead system to target one of the automated planes circling above. Turns out the undead have a thing for giant explosions. Like moths drawn to a porch lamp. And all we had to do was turn on the lights. Unfortunately, we couldn't exactly control the landing. Hendrix alerted Taylor that he was down and the diversion in play. We took out the NRC and moved. Bishop was being held underground in the security station across the tarmac. Hendrix ordered weapons down. The base was crawling with NRC soldiers and undead. No need to drop. We crossed the tarmac. The tunnel ahead led to the security station.
Very all too well.
Hendrix took out the guards. I hacked into the system to find Bishop.
Why were the NRC still at the base? It was being overrun.
They needed the cure. They kidnapped Bishop's whole team and would do whatever it took to get their hands on it. They'd torture these researchers till the dead broke down the door and ripped them all to shreds if it meant they could save their people. It wasn't personal. It was self-preservation. With the secret out about Bishop's discovery, he'd become the most wanted man in the world. The NRC were just the first to grab him. It was every country for itself. Why do you think we were there? The Winslow Accord wanted the same thing the NRC did.
You can't rationalize anything when you're put up against the wall.
Nothing about this was rational. It was instinctual, animalistic, survival. He had been escorted to an interrogation room. We had to hurry. Behind us was an undead army. Once one got a whiff, the others would come running.
damn it. I'm gonna pull it so hard.
Hendricks told Bishop who we were, and that we had to move. But Bishop refused to leave without the other researchers. His friends. Our instructions were specific. Bishop was our priority. We didn't like it. But Bishop refused to leave without them.
It sounds like you were taking an awful risk.
He said for the cure to work, he needed them. They weren't expendable. Technically, we were.
In a way, you and the NRC were not so different in what you wanted and how far you were willing to go.
Our method was different. Our reasoning was not. No one wants to sacrifice themselves to save the world. But you like to think if the moment came, you'd have it in you.
Who was inside the cell?
Lieutenant Zied Khalil, member of the Egyptian army. Back in 65, he was a guard assigned to Bishop's research station. This was how we met. Hendricks cut him down and notified Taylor we were freeing the other hostages. Taylor said we didn't have the time. The base was swarming with additional NRC forces. They weren't letting their prize go that easily. There was a tunnel full of hostile soldiers between us and our exit. A cargo elevator ahead was the only way to the surface. No telling how close the dead were behind us.
The remaining NRC forces were waiting for us above. They weren't about to let their prize prisoner go. If it meant getting the cure and saving their families, they were willing to die for it. And they weren't the only ones. We'd never seen dead killers in action before. To us, it was a spectacle. To them, it was just another day in the life. Wait a minute.
Do not be deceived by his lies. Remember your past. Remember when you first met John Taylor. Remember the truth.
Wait, this is wrong. This can't be real.
I told you I met Taylor in Zurich during the 2065 Qatardist uprising, after I became a dead killer. But here I am with Taylor, and my limbs haven't been replaced yet. I'm still human. Why did you tell me that the first time I met Taylor was Zurich?
Focus. You need to complete this memory. What was Taylor's plan?
We were still on for Exfil. But first, we had to blow the bridge. We followed Diaz. Both undead and NRC forces were converging on our position.
What the fuck, man? Really? Oh, what the hell, man? I don't have a fucking eaten eye on the other side. Bullshit. Come on, what the fuck, man? Really? He can do it, but I can't. Fuck.
again. Okay. Okay.
Paul grabbed us after the hangar. She was to take us to Moretti, so we could blow the bridge. After the bridge, we were forced inside a comm center. Moretti took point. The rendezvous with Taylor was an APC garage just ahead.
Go.
We could hear the undead screaming towards us. That wasn't all. A robot horde was moving in. Taylor would need some time to get the door open.
You were forced into the garage. What happened there?
Hendrix wanted to go back and get the other hostages. Taylor said Bishop was priority. After all, he had the cure. The rest were just collateral.
What did Taylor do?
He volunteered to take his team to get the others. We were to take Khalil and Bishop to Exfil. We got on the APC. Bishop was the most important man in the world right now. We had to get him to Exfil if it killed us. PC spun out and crashed. Hendrix moved Bishop into position. The drone evac was inbound. Once secured in the drop pod, it would return to collect. We just needed to hold back the horde.
What happened?
Airspace was compromised. They had to pull out. Bishop was priority. We were standing. We heard Taylor over the comms. He was inbound and told us to hang on. No. I can't do this. I can't live this again. No. Please.
I am sorry. You must.
No, please!
If you wish to defeat Jonas, you must. To save the world, you must relive this.
I should have died. I felt myself fade. It was over. That was the day I met John Taylor. That was the day I became a dead killer.
That was the day I became Black Ops.
That was the day you met Bishop, the man who found the cure, before he died at the Cairo aquifers. Moretti told you to find him.
On Moretti's instruction, we sought him out. We told him what we knew, which at the time was just a name, Deimos. He didn't know much, just that Deimos was responsible for the outbreak, and that a safe house in Singapore had a dossier on the guy. So we returned to Singapore. Little did we know, Go Julan had taken the city, and somehow gotten the undead to obey her. If we were going to get to the safe house, we'd have to go through them.
Oh man, not this one now. Jesus Christ, how long does this bitch go?
The vultures, sadistic scavengers, ravaged by atrocity and time, driven by fear and insanity. We saw their victims strung up on display the moment we arrived.
I hope you like this, Iceman, because this is for you.
When forced against the wall, the impurities of man can be revealed.
It was more than that. This was survivalism. When only 1% of the world's population is human, you either died and became the undead, or you survived by preying on the living.
Looking for intel. Teddy bear!
I had a bad feeling about this. Going through the undead was one thing, but vultures, they were fucking savages.
Gotta pay. Here, hold on. Oh, I forgot I'm a female.
These scavengers were well equipped. I suppose that's what you get when you prey on your fellow man. You made quick work of them.
I
Turks took point down the alley. From the sounds of it, the dead knew we were coming. Clearly, Singapore was happy to have us back in town. Overwatch confirmed the vultures were converging on the safe house. Civilians spotted on site. We didn't know if we could get through without additional collateral damage.
It's curious, the vulture's behavior. Willing to kill the living and the dead alike without prejudice. Survival of the fittest at its most primal. They act with reckless abandon without thinking of the consequences. They had to know. The more they killed other humans, the slimmer their chances became.
Don't think of them as humans. They're animals. Abandoned by any form of governing body, they dictated their own society. They were tribal. Nomadic. In their eyes, man was as much a threat as the undead. The scavengers began realizing they weren't the only humans in the area. It was a matter of time before Gojulong knew we were here. The safe house was beyond the gardens. But the gardens belonged to the dead. They smelled us lurking above. The scavengers began realizing they weren't the only humans in the area. It was a matter of time before Gojulong knew we were here. The safe house was beyond the gardens. But the gardens belonged to the dead. They smelled us lurking above.
Sam! I'm dead. Oh, bullshit.
The scavengers began realizing they weren't the only humans in the area. It was a matter of time before Gojulan knew we were here. The safe house was beyond the gardens, but the gardens belonged to the dead. They smelled us lurking above.
What the fuck, man?
The scavengers began realizing they weren't the only humans in the area. It was a matter of time before Gojulan knew we were here. The safe house was beyond the gardens, but the gardens belonged to the dead. They smelled us lurking above.
Ammo. Bitch, come on, fly down. That way you don't blow me up again. One dead buggy. Seven more to go. Another dead buggy. Another dead buggy. You at, you bitch.
Before Hendrix could take him out, the scavenger alerted Gojulan. She knew we were here. Reinforcements were moving on a checkpoint nearby, along with more dead.
Are you kidding me? Fuck, come on, really?